Good afternoon. My name is Kevin Bart Simpson. I'm the state president of the Arkansas Fraternal Order of Police. I want to welcome all of you here today for the 2018 Arkansas Law Enforcement Memorial Service. If you're sitting, please stand for the posting of colors and remain standing for the national anthem.
Can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hail at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets' red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave? Oh, the land of the free
. At this time, Chaplain Tim McMinn of the Sherwood Police Department is going to give our invocation.
Let us pray together. Father, we stand before you today to honor those who gave everything they had to keep us safe and to protect us. And we know in our hearts, Father, you know what it is and what it means to give all. We thank you for your Son and our Savior, Jesus Christ, who gave his all for us, that we might have the peace and the comfort in our hearts of knowing when we stand before you on days like this, to honor these police officers, to remember them, and to pray for their families, for the Bradens and the Weatherfords and the Mainharts, and the many other officers from all over this country who accepted the call to go out. Thank you for this time. Thank you for the comfort and the assurance you give us. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, I pray. Amen.
Please be seated. Today, we gather here to remember our heroes who have made the ultimate sacrifice in law enforcement service. But we also pay a very special tribute to the surviving family members who have been left behind. At this time, I'm going to ask Sergeant Alan Hamby, who is on the State Law Enforcement Memorial Committee, to come forward and give a memorial update.
Thank you, Mr. President. Ladies and gentlemen, brothers and sisters, I tell you, it's a distinct honor to have stood before you here for the past 14 years before President Simpson and to MC this ceremony. It was an honor, and it was something I'll never forget. I've been fortunate after that point to be appointed by Governor Asa Hutchins in 2016 to the Arkansas Law Enforcement Memorial Design Committee. I just wanted to touch base with each and every one and let you know there is a committee newly formed as of 2016. We're working hard. If you have any thoughts, desires, things you might want to see on this wall, please get in contact with me. I will be around to the end of the service, and I'll have some cards and stuff if you'd like to give me some designs. We are law enforcement officers. We're not architects. But we like to make sure that this state is proud of us when we get through with our job. So again, thank you for giving me a few minutes.
At this time, it is my distinct honor to introduce the governor of the great state of Arkansas, Governor Asa Hutchinson.
Thank you. This is an important occasion that we remember those officers that have given of themselves and made such a sacrifice for our safety and for the rule of law in our nation. Whenever I worked in Washington, D.C., one of the paths to the United States Capitol was to walk through the Peace Officers Memorial there in Washington, D.C. It always caused me to reflect upon the sacrifice of those that have given of themselves across our nation. And of course, at the U.S. DEA that I was administrator of, we have our wall of fallen DEA agents over the course of the years. And I've attended many of those, and it's important that we here in Arkansas, and it's important that I as governor, that we have this memorial wall, this place of serenity, this place of remembrance for those officers that have made such a sacrifice. And so in 2017, we are grateful for Lieutenant Kevin Meinhardt. We are grateful for Lieutenant Patrick Weatherford and for Deputy Sheriff Timothy Brader, for them and their families that have given the ultimate sacrifice. In 2018, of course, we lost Officer Oliver Johnson, Jr. And so hopefully we will not lose any more this year and next year. But we also know the reality of our society today. And your presence is necessary for safety, for enforcement, and for the public good. Thank you for what you have done. Thank you for your sacrifices. And God bless all those that wear the uniform in blue. God bless you.
This time we're going to have the roll call of heroes. Deputy Timothy Allen Braden of the Drew County Sheriff's Department. Speaking on his behalf is Drew County Sheriff Mark Gober.
Good afternoon. It's a place none of us want to be, but when the time comes, we have to be here. Timothy left behind his wife Alyssa and four young children. Timothy was a role model for my guys in my work, my deputies. He did his job the correct way, the right way, the honest way. He was a very conscientious man and a deputy, meaning that if you asked him what he did or what he thought about it, he said, I don't know. He wouldn't say that. He had a meaning and a reason behind everything he did or did not do. He was very focused. And just like the name etched today, it's bright. That name will fade, but his memory and what he gave to us, our department, and his family never will. Thank you.
Lieutenant Patrick Neil Weatherford of the Newport Police Department. Speaking will be Lieutenant Alan Edwards of the Newport Police Department.
If y'all bear with me, I bet I've read this 1,000 times and had it memorized, but being flooded with a lot of emotion today. I know God will give me strength to give great tribute to our officers. I am very honored today to be here before y'all on this beautiful day and to briefly speak on behalf of our department at this memorial service honoring all of our fallen officers. On June the 12th, 2017 at 5:45 p.m., Lieutenant Patrick Weatherford responded along with other Newport Police Department officers to a call of a vehicle break-in in Rimmel Park. A description was given of the suspect, and Lieutenant Weatherford located the suspect, and a foot pursuit ensued. The suspect, a 16-year-old male, turned and brandished a handgun and shot and critically injured Lieutenant Weatherford, and then turned and fired at another officer as he was fleeing the scene. Lieutenant Weatherford succumbed to his injuries a short time later at our local hospital. Romans 12:21 says, "Do not be overcome by evil, but overcome evil with good." Patrick was a great example of a good man. Patrick was a devoted husband and father and was truly a great friend. Patrick's greatly missed and our hearts have been broken. The supportive outpour of our community, our state, our nation has been felt, and for that we are grateful. Patrick was very loved and missed terribly. Our hearts are healing, although at times the tears reappear. We will push forward with the legacy that Patrick left us with and know that he is watching over us. Thank you very much.
Lieutenant Kevin Clyde Mainhart of the Yell County Sheriff's Department. Speaking will be Yell County Sheriff Bill Gilkey.
Remembering Kevin Mainhart, you try to find the words to say, as I have the past many days. But three words come to mind: honor, dynamic, and leadership. Kevin Mainhart was a man of honor. He was an officer of honor. And speaking on behalf of the Yell County Sheriff's Department, myself, I don't think any of us in our career, in maybe our lifetime, will ever achieve a greater honor than knowing Kevin Mainhart and working along beside him. Dynamic. Kevin was a dynamic person. Everything that Kevin done, he done for the people of Yell County and the state of Arkansas. Thank you, Kevin, for everything that you have done for us in the past, now, and your leadership that you will still provide to us in the future. Thank you.
Now for our hero of the past that we've put on the wall today. Chief Keith Bradford from the Terrell PD. Speaking will be Lieutenant Darrell Pruitt of the Crittenden County Sheriff's Department. Thank you, sir.
Hello and thank y'all. I'm honored to be able to speak here tonight or this afternoon. I've had the privilege of working with two heroes that are on this wall this year. Kevin Mainhart was a retired captain with West Memphis Police Department in Crittenden County, and Chief Keith Bradford. I could tell you a lot of funny stories, but the best story that sticks out was Miss Bradford told me when we were coming down to Mayflower this year was how Chief Bradford had to take and pick up his grandson from school and how he would get just fighting mad if Chief Bradford didn't show up in his police car to pick him up. So that story got to me. He was a good guy. He took care of both his parents as they were in their later years, and he always kept us laughing on patrol. Unfortunately, he had a heart attack after responding to a pursuit and went home way too early. Miss Bradford, you know that we will all miss him, and we always think of you and your family. And if there's anything we can do at the Sheriff's Office, please don't hesitate to let us know.
This time, Kim Pfeiffer is going to come and make a presentation.
I was asked to read a poem or something to you all today, and I was reminded of something by Paul Harvey that he did on the radio a number of years ago. Some of you may be too young to remember Paul Harvey, but I remember him. And one thing you probably don't know about Paul Harvey was his dad was a policeman. He was killed in the line of duty in 1921. He was a Tulsa police officer. But the thing that I'm going to read from Paul Harvey was something entitled, What Are Policemen Made Of? Sometime you may just see it entitled Policeman. But he says, a policeman is a composite of what all men are, I guess, a mingling of saint and sinner, dust and deity. Cull statistics, wave the fan over the stinkers. Underscore the instances of dishonesty and brutality because they are news. What they really mean is they're exceptional. They are unusual. They're not commonplace. The policeman must be a minister, a social worker, a diplomat, a tough guy, and a gentleman. And of course, he'd have to be a genius because he'll have to feed a family on a policeman's salary. Now, we'll consider all of you guys family. We're all family, we're humans. And it's a shame what we put up with today, sometimes in the news. But I respect all of you and say thank you for everything you do. Thank you.
At this time, please stand for the playing of Amazing Grace. At this time, Sergeant Herman Hutton of the Pulaski County Sheriff's Department is going to give our benediction.
Let us pray. Gracious and glorious Father God, we lift your name up because only you are worthy of praise, Father. Right now, Father, we ask a special blessing upon these families that are here. We ask that you fill them with mercy and grace and love and peace, Father. Lord, we thank you for what Jesus told us, that no greater gift hath a man than to lay down his life for a friend. And Lord, Father, we remember those right now. Father God, we especially thank you for the Lord Jesus Christ who went to the cross for each of us. And Father, we thank you for his mercy, for his grace, and it is in his mighty name I pray. Amen.